What if I told you there's an easy way to stop wasting money on AI subscriptions and keep your weird chat conversations private? You know, the ones you wouldn't want your therapist to see? By the end of this video, you'll have everything you need to build your very own free AI software suite with no subscriptions and no compromising your privacy. We'll cover tools that let you chat with AI, analyze documents, write code, and generate images. Let's dive in. There are a number of reasons to run AI locally. First, I think we're all tired of getting nickeled and dimed to death with a never-ending parade of subscription services. The privacy is also a big consideration, especially if we work with proprietary information that we just can't share with the rest of the world. Maybe you don't want to let the whole world know how much you're into bagpipe covers of death metal songs. Or maybe you don't want ChatGPT to steal your brilliant business plan for giraffe-based window cleaning solutions. The two primary tools we're going to look at today, LM Studio and Ollama, are very simple to install and will allow us to run free open source models such as DeepSeek and Llama. Then we'll take a look at an AI client called Chatbox that we can use as a friendly and consistent user interface. And we'll look at ways to do AI image generation locally. For that, we'll use Diffusion Bee on the Mac. And for Windows, we can use a great tool called Pinokio to install a number of different image generators. Now to do all this, we'll need to have some newer hardware that can handle running AI models. And that generally means either an NVIDIA GPU or an M-series Mac, which is what I'm using. It's an M3 iMac, which does a pretty decent job with AI, but it doesn't have the memory to handle the really big models. So first, we'll take a look at LM Studio. Getting started with LM Studio is incredibly easy. We just head to their website, download the installer, and run it. No complicated setup required. When we run LM Studio the first time, it'll offer to help us download our first model file, even suggesting a model based on how much memory our system has. But I'm going to skip that for the moment, because first I want to change to the location where models are downloaded, so that I don't fill up my main drive. On the My Models tab, we can change the models directory up at the top of the screen. I'll set mine to use a folder on an SSD drive I have attached to my iMac. Once that's done, we'll need to download our first model from the Discover tab. Because I've only got 16 gigabytes of RAM, my machine can only handle the smaller model files that are typically 2 to 5 gigabytes in size. We'll start by downloading the Llama 3.2 model from Meta, which is a great general purpose model. Once a model is downloaded, we can go to the Chat tab and then start interacting with it. And on the Developer tab, we can run an AI server that we can then connect to via third-party clients, or from our own apps and scripts if we want to experiment with creating our own custom AI tools. By the way, I'll put links in the video description to the tools we're looking at today, all of which are free and open source, though one of the products does offer an optional paid service. And also, if you're enjoying this video and learning something today, please hit that like button and consider subscribing to the channel. Next, we'll look at Ollama, which is another popular tool for running AI models locally. Ollama is also super easy to install. However, it doesn't have a fancy GUI interface. Instead, it's just pure terminal goodness. But where Ollama really shines is acting as a server so that we can use other tools to interact with it. And like LM Studio, Ollama also has a way to change the folder where models are downloaded, though we'll need to set an environment variable. In Windows, we can do that via System Properties, setting the Ollama Models variable to the folder we want to use. And on Mac and Linux, we do that with a setenv command in the terminal. Back on the Ollama website, we can select from their list of popular models and then easily copy the terminal command needed for installation. Once the model is downloaded, we can interact with it directly in the terminal. But for a better experience, we can use another free and open source tool called Chatbox, which we can download from their website. Chatbox is a cross-platform AI chat client that gives us a nice friendly interface for working with the models running in Ollama. But Chatbox can also use our API keys from OpenAI, Claude, and Gemini if we have them. Or we can also use Chatbox's optional paid service, which gives us access to the popular models like ChatGPT and Claude, plus a few extra features like built-in image generation and web access. But we'll select Ollama as our provider and leave the host and port pointing to the local Ollama server. And by the way, if you hadn't noticed, the port number that Ollama uses is 11434, which sort of spells out the word llama, like somebody's vanity license plate. With our provider set to Ollama, we can do typical AI things like have conversations, make charts out of data, get help with coding, and we can also give it documents and ask the AI questions about them. You may hear this referred to as RAG, which stands for Retrieval Augmented Generation. So one of the other big attractions in generative AI is image and video creation. Now the video generators are still pretty new, but image creators have been around for quite a while now. If we're using a Mac, we can grab the free and open source app Diffusion Bee for a super easy way to get started generating AI images locally on our computer. On the Windows and Linux side, we don't have Diffusion Bee yet, but instead we can use a powerful tool called Pinokio to easily build lots of free and open source AI tools, including several image creators. Pinokio is kind of like an app store that completely automates the often complicated setup and configuration of open source software. With it, we can select from a huge curated library of AI tools and install whatever we like, often with just a few clicks. And for image generation, we can use Pinokio to run a tool called Focus, which gives us a simple web UI to create our AI images, a lot like Diffusion Bee. Now, before we wrap up, I have to point out the big drawback of running all these AI tools locally, and that's the quality of the output. Most home computers, like mine, are simply not powerful enough to run the gigantic models used by ChatGPT, Claude, and Gemini. So their results will almost always be somewhat better. So you'll have to decide if that's a fair trade-off for the privacy and the cost savings. So with these tools, we now have our very own AI software suite running locally, and it won't ask you to sign up for a 7-day free trial. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe to Gigabyte Labs for more tech videos like this. See you next time.